His Excellency Mr. Emomali Rahmon, President of the Republic of Tajikistan. Your Excellency, you have the floor.
Mr. President, distinguished heads of delegations, dear ladies and gentlemen, current climate change is due mainly caused by the individual and is fraught with serious negative consequences for all countries and for each individual around the globe. This problem is particularly acute in Tajikistan, which difficult geographic conditions make it one of the most vulnerable to ongoing climate change in the Eurasian continent. The average annual temperature in Tajikistan increased to 1 degree centigrade over the past 60 years, and the number of days with heavy rainfall have become more often, and frequency of natural disasters increased, accompanied by economic losses. Abnormal weather phenomena have been increasingly observed during this period in Tajikistan. Only in the period from 1988 to 2009, the country has suffered four severe drought years, and in winter in 2007-2008 was the most rigorous in the history of the country. All these phenomena in turn led to severe negative consequences that affect the living standards and significantly reduced capability and potential of the country in achieving sustainable development. And to our deepest regret, sometimes people lose their lives. In addition to that, Tajikistan is among the countries with the lowest impact on the global warming. Tajikistan stands at 150 among 200 countries in the world for carbon dioxide emissions, and it stands the last in Central Asian region, and the rate in its share in the regional value of emission amounts less than 5%. It explains that hydropower plants generate more than 95% of power in the country. Distinguished delegates, one of the most complex problems facing humanity in connection with ongoing climate change is reducing the number and quality of freshwater resources around the globe. This issue has a particular relevance for Central Asia, where water is the basis of socio-economic development. I'd like to draw attention to the fact that about 60% of water used by countries of Central Asia generates in the territory of Tajikistan. However, over the past decades, intensive melting of snowfields and glaciers, which are main source of freshwater in Central Asia, has led to simply disappearance of thousand glaciers, along with the impact of climate change on the active melting of glaciers. Desiccation of the Aral Sea has influenced this process to some extent as well. Every year, thousands of toes of dust and soil blown up by the wind from the bottom of the dry Aral Sea into the atmosphere and are diffused to vast areas. And according to the estimation of experts, some part of salt settles in the glaciers of the Pamir and Tian Shan, facilitating the intensive melting down. The history of Central Asia is aware of consequences that may occur if connivance and natural resource management takes place. Having predetermined an actual catastrophe of the Aral Sea, we should not allow the disappearance of glaciers, which are the source of life in Central Asia. In this regard, I believe that there is an urgent need to establish the International Fund for Preservation of Glaciers, which would bring together the countries of the region and the international community in this strategically important sector. And along with this, for the view of ensuring water security in Central Asia and the terms of demographic explosion and uncontrolled new land development, as well as careless and wasteful water consumption, Republic of Tajikistan appeals to the United Nations and its relevant institutions to conduct an integrated assessment of the impact on the environment by absolutely outdated and inefficient water consumption system on the region and a huge amount of water reservoirs downstream countries. As namely, it is a rational use of water resources by irrigated agriculture and construction of huge reservoirs, the volume of which exceeds current level of the Aral Sea 1.5 times, has led to the catastrophe of this formerly large sea. Dear ladies and gentlemen, Tajikistan fully supports the terms of the new climate agreement, which includes restricting and reducing consumption of fossil fuel, increased use of renewable source of energy, reforestation and improvement of land management. Along with this, we believe that the year of comparison, as stated in the recommendations of the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, should remain 1990. We also welcome the new agreement provided for an initiative to increase financial and technical assistance to developed countries to reduce emissions, technology transfer and adaptation activities as far as precisely by virtue of limited possibilities they most of all face with serious negative consequences of climate change in the world and the global warming. And as Tajikistan today suffers from shortage of electricity and heating despite its huge hydropower potential, in this respect, industrially developed countries, which are major emitters into the atmosphere, should play a key role. However, our country is ready to make a contribution to improving the climate. Today, about 70% of electricity generated in Central Asian countries accounts for thermal power plants, which annually emit millions of tons of carbon dioxide gas into the atmosphere. And at the same time, Tajikistan has huge hydropower potential, which is estimated at 527 billion kilowatt hours per year, that at the given instant uses 5-6% only. This capacity exceeds the current needs of the countries of Central Asia 3 times, and its further development would not only reduce emissions of billions of tons of carbon dioxide gases into the atmosphere, but also considerably save reserves of oil, gas and coal, which are intensively used by some countries in the region for power generation. Distinguished delegates, Tajikistan has initiated 2 major UN General Assembly water resolutions, the Declaration of the International Year of Fresh Water and the International Decade of Action Water for Life, and is actively pursuing a water policy at regional and global arenas. In this context, this year, my country has once again initiated the resolution of the UN General Assembly on the mid-term comprehensive review of the International Decade for Action Water for Life 2005-2015, the key objective of which is achieving the internationally agreed goals on water. According to the resolution adopted recently by consensus, it is proposed to hold an interactive high-level dialogue of the UN General Assembly to discuss the implementation of the International Decade on March 22nd. back in 2010 on the World War Today. This event aims to launch a broad discussion to progress made in implementing of objectives of the decade and the necessary ground for the International High Level Conference on the Midterm Comprehensive Review of the Implementation of the Decade at June 2010. We take this opportunity to invite governments, UN institutions, international organizations and other interested parties to participate in this important event. Thank you for your attention.